Hey campers, welcome back to our channel. My name is Mark and you're here for coffee and card games. So grab yourself a hot cup of joe, have a seat, and let's chat about Star Wars Unlimited. We have been working our way through rating and discussing every card that is coming out in the first set launching for Star Wars Unlimited, The Spark of Rebellion. And we are currently making our way through the command cards, the green faction, and we are on the last set. We only have a couple cards to talk about in this video, so let's get to it as we look at the legendary cards, the ones probably going to be most anxious to get our hands on and to talk about. We're going to go through these four cards one at a time, chat about where they might see play, and talk about what we see them being synergistic with, and if they're ever going to get to the table or not. Let's take a look. The first card that we're going to look at is this Darth Vader card. Darth Vader is a 7-mana villainy and command card. It is a 5 attack, 7 health. 5 attack, 7 health. Pretty beefy, not crazy for 7 mana, but pretty beefy. Has ambush the turn that it's played. It does get to ready and can attack in to another creature, not into a base, but it's going to get a chance to remove something. And then he says, when played, search the top 10 cards of your deck for any number of villainy units with a combined cost of 3 or less and play each of them for free. So this is 7 mana, but you figure you are getting 10 mana worth of value out of him, right? Or you could consider it saying, I'm kind of playing 4 mana for him because I'm getting 3 mana worth of units out of my deck from villainy cards and placing them on the board. He himself is going to have ambush as well. I think Vader is very powerful if you're going to be playing a ramp variant of this card, of this deck. I don't know how quickly or easily it's going to be at 7. Of course, the hyperspace look of this with Vader coming through his hand, commanding out there with the snowtroopers behind him on Hoth is an absolutely gorgeous card. I love this card. I'm so glad that Vader came in as a legendary. Seems really powerful to me. Fits the command, I think. Faction really well. It's the Force, Imperial, and Sith keyword. How freaking cool is that? Really love him, and I actually think he's good. I think he's actually very good. If you can get to 7 reliably in a game of Star Wars Unlimited, if the meta's not too fast, your opponent's not too fast, I think this is a good card. You don't know what you're going to get in those top 10. That's true, but very likely you're going to get at least a couple of villainy cards in there, and you're going to get to smash them onto the board along with him and get a little bit of extra value out of him. It's not going to happen every time, but I would say it's pretty reliable that it's going to happen with a pretty decent level of consistency that you're going to see some 1s, 2s, and 3s. You're going to be able to race onto the board. I'd say probably the highest chance is you're just going to get like 1, 2, or 1, 3. You're probably just going to get 1 unit with Vader. But even with that, it's probably still worth it. I think Vader's good. I'm really happy with him. I think he's powerful. I think they made him well, and it's kind of thematic too, right? He comes in and he's coming in, you know, guns blazing, but he's also coming in with somebody, right? He's always rolling with the stormtroopers. And you find a couple of those, you know, if you're playing him in an aggression, maybe like a green red, you get the Imperial stormtroopers in that, toss a couple of 1-cost stormtroopers out, could be really cool. It would be thematic anyway. Whether it'd be good, I don't know, but it'd be thematic. Okay, next. The Devastator, an even more expensive card that is from Villainy and Command. I'm just going to go ahead and put it in hyperspace mode now, because we all know it's deserving of it. Although, to be honest with you, the hyperspace isn't all that impressive. There's really nothing in the artwork that's being hidden by the border. I think when the border comes off and it goes to hyperspace is most impressive when something comes into view that wasn't there before. But the Devastator, just kind of getting more of the same. Getting that underside, it's cool. I like it. It is a 10 resource, 10 attack, 10 health, Imperial vehicle, and capital ship. 10, that is not easy to get to. Unless you can cheat this out, man, this is not easy to get to. It is a 10-10 with Sentinel, so no one's going to be coming through this thing very easily. It also has Overwhelm, which is very strong. And then when played, you may deal damage to a unit equal to the number of resources you control, which is almost always going to be 10. So this thing's going to come down as a 10-mana 10-10. It's going to block up the space lane. It is going to be able to crush through some TIE fighters or some X-Wings and crush your opponent's base with Overwhelm. And then when it hits the board, it's also going to just sling at least probably 10 points of damage at something. Almost for sure going to completely just demolish your opponent. I would say this card's actually absolute trash. It could just be waylaid. It could just be, you know, exhausted over and over again. It could just be removed with Vanquish. If it wasn't for the when play, deal damage equal to a unit, equal to the number of resources you control. That does allow you to get a little bit of a swing, and then your opponent does need to come back on this. So it does let you get some immediate value. I still don't think many games are going to get to 10 resources, specifically because of the draw two function and the ability for aggressors to really have an upper hand. And a lot of times as aggressor has priority. If you could cheat this out really early, great. I just don't think that the game yet has the ramping tools that are consistent enough. There's not enough of them for them to be consistent enough in a deck for this card to be really good. It's cool. I wish it was good. I don't think it's going to be. Home one. This is another space unit. It is Heroism. 8 resources, also command. A Rebel Vehicle Capital Ship. So this is also the Capital Ship for the Rebels versus the Capital Ship that was for the Imperials we looked at before. 7 attack, 7 health, beautiful in hyperspace. 7 attack, 7 health, really not much more you're getting from it. A little bit of view of the nebula. I wish there was more of a space battle around it when you pulled that border off. But as it turns out, the space battle is pretty much all contained inside the bordered area. You don't really, you know, maybe you get like a TIE fighter gets revealed. Maybe that's about it. Not much. Restore 2, so when you attack with this, you are going to heal your base 2. And then each other friendly unit gains restore 1. Okay, that's a way to start getting some health back. Not bad. When played, play a, I think that's a Heroism unit from your discard pile. It costs 3 less. Now, this is very similar to Vader. You know, like, at what time are you going to have 8 plus additional resources? So you're probably just going to be digging a 1, a 2, or a 3 Heroism unit out of your graveyard or your discard pile to be able to pull it back. I love that. I like the graveyard mechanic. I like digging into the graveyard, but you're probably, let's just be realistic, you're probably not playing this so that you can play another big thing on that turn. You're probably playing this and then you're pulling a 1, a 2, or a 3 out for free and putting on the board. That's not bad. It gives you more value. You know, you get a 3 cost out of this, get like a 3/4 or 4/3. You know, you're looking at, you know, 7, 8, 9, 11, 10 of stats maybe, or a 10 of stats over 2 bodies for 8. It's not bad. That's not bad. And you're giving everything else restore. Now this thing doesn't, it does do a little thing immediately. Could be good. I think it's more playable realistically than Devastator is. And I think Devastator is a cool card and it does something when it comes down. I think it's more playable than that, but it's very expensive. These cards are very expensive and it's going to make it hard to be able to use it. Let's take a look at the last one. Interesting that we actually have two villainy cards, only one Heroism card, and then one double faction. Let's take a look at the hyperspace of this card. It does look nice. The characters in the background, eh. Now this is Command, which is the name of the faction. It is 4, but it is a double green icon. So this is always going to cost you 4 if you have 2 greens, but very likely this is going to end up costing you probably 6, you know, unless you're not playing a double green faction. Once again, I think that Hera has the ability to play double green and still get a wide variety of cards because of her Spectre stuff. And then you could play this. So I think this might be like a must-have in a we'll see, maybe a must-have in a Hera deck. And it says you can choose 2 and you can do them in any order. Give 2 experience tokens to a unit, so +2/+2. Give a friendly unit deals damage equal to its power to a non-unique enemy unit. That could be very strong, you know, just a direct damage hit. Put this event into play as a resource, so it serves as an additional ramp. That's kind of cool. And return a unit from your discard pile to your hand. Now, I happen to know there's other ones that are double factions that I think are much nicer than this. This isn't bad, but it's not great. It's not bad, but it's not great. +2/+2, yeah, even though it's permanent, eh. I think that the ones here are the one that deals damage equal to friendly unit's power, and then maybe ramping. Can you imagine on 4 removing something and ramping? It could be good. That could be good if you ran like 3 of these and you know, this was another way to reliably ramp, play this in a Hera deck with double green, let you get out some of your specters a little bit earlier. Yeah, it's hard to say. I like these cards. I think they're super cool. These choose things and do them in any order, I think is super dope. I like it. I'm not in love with it. I think the one in yellow, in cunning, is better than this. We'll take a look at that in a different video, but it's cool. But it's very cool. Okay, guys, that's actually going to do it. That's all of the cards now we've covered for Command. All of the green cards. Common, uncommon, rare, legendary, heroes, bases, everything has been covered on this channel. So if you missed any of it, go check out the channel and be sure to like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon so you'll know the next time we put something out here. I make a lot of Star Wars Unlimited content, but there are Lorcana artists. We have a podcast that covers digital card games of all types as well. Lots of content here if you're a card game enthusiast. If you're a Star Wars enthusiast, you're just getting into card games. It's also a great place to learn more about card games and learn more about Star Wars Unlimited. So stop by and hang out with us. Pull up a chair, sit by the fire with us, and become part of the community. You can find links to a lot of other things in the description of this video. I want to thank you for tuning in for this one, and I'll see you guys in the next video.